This program reads an integer and executes a for loop for that many times. As usual, stdio.h is included, main is defined. The integer variables I and n are declared. The user will be asked to enter an integer number n. Whatever user enters, it will be read into the variable n. Let us try to simulate this program. Let we assume that the user has entered 5. Initial value of I is taken as 1. Is I less than n? Currently, I value is 1, n value is 5. Is I less than or equal to n? Yes. Thus, the loop is going to get executed once. I value will be incremented by 1. I value will be incremented by 1. Is I less than or equal to n? Currently I value is 2. 2 less than or equal to 5? Yes. Thus, the loop is going to get executed once more.
I value will be incremented by 1.
Is I less than or equal to n? Currently I value is 3. 3 less than or equal to 5? Yes. Thus, the loop is going to get executed once more.
I value will be incremented by 1.
Is I less than or equal to n? Yes. That is, current value of I is 4. 4. Is it less than or equal to 5? Yes. Thus, the loop is going to get executed once more.
I value will be incremented by 1.
Is I less than or equal to n? Currently I value is 5. 5. Is it less than or equal to 5? Yes. Thus, the loop is going to get executed once more.
I value will be incremented by 1.
Is I less than or equal to n? Current value of I is 6. 6. Is it less than or equal to 5? No. Thus, the loop control will come out from the loop. That is, as of now, the loop got executed 5 times. As n value is 5, it got executed 5 times. If n value would have been some other number, the loop is going to get executed that many times. Thus,